morning from Our Lady of Hope. I hope everyone stays off to a great start. I had a little bit of a crazy morning. I began my day going to BJ's and standing on a long line waiting to get in. Got a little bit of a sense what it was like to stand on a Russian bread line. And then when I came back here to the rectory with my groceries, I hear a bit of commotion outside and I see one of the mothers on the block scraping the honor roll sticker off her car. I guess a little bit of frustration at home. Just kidding. But I hope all of our parents are doing well and doing the best they can to keep their children healthy, positive, and making sure that they continue to learn. We talk a lot in the church about vocations. Vocations meaning one's calling in life. In a very strict sense, we talk about vocations to the priesthood, we talk about vocations to marriage, but we also recognize that there are many vocations in life. This is rooted in our belief and understanding that God blesses each person with particular gifts that are oriented to a specific purpose and to a way of life. It's often hard for us to articulate, those of us who feel we've been called to do something in life, to articulate exactly how we knew that. It's hard to put into words that deep conviction that God has called us to do something. I think we could add a new criteria to what it means to understand that one is called to do something in life. I believe we could recognize that someone has a vocation and is living their vocation when they are faithful, even in the most difficult circumstances. We could look at so many people in society today who are living their vocation, their God-given call, as they live heroic lives in the most difficult circumstances. We look at our medical professionals, the nurses and doctors who are showing up each day to care for those who are sick and to be with those who are dying. We could look at those who serve in the fire department, in the police department, EMTs, that go to work every day knowing that they themselves could become sick, that they're putting themselves at risk and their family members, but nonetheless, they remain faithful to their calling. Personally, I think of the priests who continue to minister to those who are sick and dying. Already in Italy, more than 50 priests have died who are ministering to the sick and the dying. A beautiful example. Many of us might be struggling at this time to live our vocations, to be faithful in these difficult times. We need to ask God to keep us faithful and to give us the strength we need to be faithful to the end. I think it's worth us reminding ourselves that we don't make the big decisions in life at stressful times or times where we're knowing anguish. We only make life decisions in peaceful times when our thoughts are clear and our emotions are regulated. And so for now, we don't make big decisions. We trust in God and we take one day at a time. God bless you and see you soon.